It's been quite a while since patch 11.0 brought us a new character and new balance changes, and I couldn't help but notice there weren't any Falco buffs. While I went through the 7 stages of grief, I took Falco to the god-awful training mode Nintendo decided to bless us with and took out my frustration on Mario. Finally, as I had started to accept that there must be no god, I started thinking up ways to even the playing field and try to perfect the art of stealth biking. Quick side note, for the sake of this video, most of the time when I refer to Mithra and Pyra, I will not be calling them the Aegis, but instead Hythra, because it makes some people mad. And honestly, it feels me. And so, with Pythra being widely considered yet another top-tier DLC, if I could make that matchup kinda good for Falco, that's kinda like a buff, right? Well, luckily for Falco, stall spiking works quite well on both Mithra and Pyra. Just, be careful of Mithra.
Uh-oh.
If you don't know what stall spiking is and want to know how to do it, I made a full video about it, which includes examples of it being used on every character. You can check it out by clicking the notification, checking the description, or finding it in the playlist at the end. I do recommend you check out at least the first 3 minutes of that, however. With stall spike working on Pythra, I think that makes the matchup at least a little less painful. Here's a quick update of the stall spike's viability chart and how it's changed with the new characters and new information since it was first made. And how Pyra ruined the perfectly square character select screen we once had. May it rest in peace. Now I want to go over some more details and tips about stall spiking that I've learned thanks to you and thanks to further testing. Quickly, before I do, I just wanted to thank you for the support and positivity on the first video. If you like this video and want to see more, please consider subscribing and liking the video. It really helps the channel grow, and I love making fun and informative content for all of you. I really appreciate the feedback, and I would love to make more. Thank you again. Firstly, let's start out with pressuring. I didn't specify in the first video, and I really should've, but if you miss the spike, as long as you release down before you start to fall after using stall spike, you can put your opponent into a ledge trump scenario. This pressures them even further and even basically guarantees a kill 20 or 30% earlier on most characters. Simply ledge chump them into a back air, and that's it. Now, if your opponent knows this, they'll likely buff a roll get up, so be wary of that. Stall spiking doesn't really kill until over 100-110% versus most characters, especially if they still have their jump. But two framing an ultimate doesn't give the opponent their jump back, and it'll not only catch a lot of people off guard, but it'll kill characters much, much earlier. For example, with no Rage versus Fox on Final Destination, stall spike doesn't start to kill until a round as high as 124% if the opponent still has their jump. But when it two frames, it starts to kill at around 48%, making it kill a whopping 76% earlier. On a character like Wolf, who dies at 63% even with their jump, without their jump, they'll die at as low as 23% when two framed. That's huge. The kill percent will vary depending on each character's weight, jump height, your amount of rage, their up special travel distance, so be wary of all of that. Besides, if you hit this, whether they pitifully fall to their death or delay the recovery for too long, you can net really early kills for stealing their jump. My favorite play is to land a stall spike, grab ledge immediately, and drop down into a dare. Yes, some characters die to this at zero. Next, let's move on to counterplay and conditioning. The reason stall spike avoids trading most of the time is because it's decently disjointed below Falco. Only his leg really sticks out, and for some reason, it still trades more often than not, so I don't know. I'm not complaining. However, part of the reason why it still wins is because a lot of the time it's two-framing and not just trading with their up B, meaning that there is some counterplay to this that you should be aware of. Your opponent can hold down to delay grabbing the ledge, effectively covering themselves from being two-framed for as long as the recovery protects them. This obviously works better for some characters than others, so if you're trying not to get stall spiked, maybe don't hold down with characters like Pikachu, for example. Another counterplay to this tech a lot of the time is to recover higher, which is really good for Falco. I think if done right, you can basically turn a ton of offstage situations into a 50-50. Because alternatively, if you can force an air dodge or a low recovery by pressuring the opponent, you can give yourself more chances to land a stall spike. Force them to recover low and risk the stall spike, or force them to recover high and risk a different kind of death. While stall spike lines up really well with the startup and travel time of a ton of recoveries and is pretty non-committal, it's definitely important to not go for a stall spike every time, because your opponent can often delay the recovery, rip it early, whatever. The timing for each character varies, so they can mix up the timing to avoid it. Be careful. And a final quick note, while I showed it working on some horizontal side specials, I really don't recommend this versus Wolf, Falcon, Ganon, or anyone else this might trade with, or straight up lose to. The hitbox is under Falco after all, not behind him. If you have any questions or have anything else to add, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much again for watching. It means the world to me that you guys have liked what I've been putting out so far, and I hope I can continue to do more. If you want to see more, please consider subscribing and liking the video. Thank you again. Peace.
Sign up, fuck it, let's get the moolah. Yeah. All my niggas wanna get the bag, but I just wanna stay home and play Smash. Yeah.